Whether you're a complete beginner who has never touched Blender before, or whether you have some Blender experience and are just looking for a short and fun exercise, you're in the right place. My name is Josh Bartels with 3Division, and in the next 11 minutes, we are going to learn how to make this lollipop from scratch. Let's go. First, you'll need to download and install Blender. Go to blender.org, hit the big download button on the front, select download Blender for the newest version, and it will be downloaded to your machine. Go ahead and open it and follow the system prompts to get Blender installed, and I'll meet you over there. When you first open Blender, this is what you're going to see, a splash screen, but we're going to ignore that. Just click out here into what's called the 3D viewport and we are ready to go. First, we'll need to delete these default objects. To do that, I'm going to click and drag across this spot in the 3D viewport and hit X on my keyboard once I have those selected. Select delete, and now they are gone. We are going to start by creating the lollipop stick. So let's go to Add up here in the top menu, select Mesh and Cylinder. Now, this cylinder is way too big for our lollipop. We need to actually scale it down. So I'm going to scale it by a factor of 25%. So let's hit S on our keyboard for the scale shortcut. And then before we click anything with our mouse, let's just type in 0.25 to scale to 25% of its original size, and then just hit Enter. Now we have a lollipop stick that's a lot smaller. Now, in order to navigate the viewport, all you have to do is click and drag with your middle mouse button, and that will pivot you around the object that is in focus. You can zoom in and out by scrolling up and down on the mouse wheel, and then you can change your view to front, side, or top view with the keys on your number pad. So you have 1 for front view, 7 on the number pad for top view, and 3 on the number pad for side view. But what I want to be in right now is the front view. So hit the number pad 1 to move to front view. Now, obviously, this, if we zoom in, this is not the shape of a lollipop stick. We need to scale this thing. So I'm going to scale it again, but this time I only want to scale it on what's called the Z axis, this up and down axis in our scene. So hit S on your keyboard, and then before pressing anything else, hit the Z key on the keyboard. That will constrain the scale to the Z axis. And then this time, let's just type in 25 so that we scale it up by a factor of 25. Now that looks pretty good. If we scroll around here, we've got a lollipop stick. Fantastic. Now what I want to do next is to add the sphere to create the candy. So let's hit the Add button up here again, go to Mesh, and then we're going to go to this UV sphere option. And now there is our candy part of the lollipop. It's not where we want it to be, so hit the G key on the keyboard in order to grab it. Now you'll see that you can move your mouse around to replace it. Hit Z on the keyboard again to constrain the movement to the Z axis, and let's just put it up here at the top of our lollipop stick, and let's move back to front view. Now we need to scale this up to look right, so let's scale our lollipop up until things look proportionally correct, and that seems pretty good for me. Let's go back to our front view, and let's zoom in on the sphere. Now, if you find that you're zooming in at the center of the world instead of the sphere, you can hit the period key on your number pad of your keyboard, and that will focus your view on this mesh. Now, we need to change what this mesh looks like in order to create the lollipop shape that I want. So let's hit Tab on the keyboard while we have that object selected with a left click. Let's hit Tab, and now you'll see that we have access to these individual points that make up the sphere. These points are called vertices. You can change between Vertex Select Mode, Edge Select Mode up here in the top left, where you're selecting edges, the line between two vertices, or you can select a face, which is one of these polygons that make up the surface of the object. In this case, let's stay in this vertex select mode, and I'm going to switch to wireframe view mode. Right now, if I hit Z on my keyboard, you'll see this little pie menu, and you can see that the solid is blue. That's because we're in solid mode. But let's go to wireframe. That turns it to somewhat of an X-ray view, where we can see through these objects, which is exactly what we want because I want to select all of the vertices of this line. Now I'm going to show you how to do an operation called a bevel. Hit Control on your keyboard and the B key. And now you'll see this little line has been created between your cursor and the center point of that selection. But if I start dragging that line out, it begins creating a cut, and it basically is splitting these in two. I just want to scale it up just a little bit. We don't need it very far, just a little there. Now click and drag to select this top portion of the mesh, and then hit G on the keyboard again, and Z to constrain the movement on the Z. And we're just going to pull it up just a touch to give it that little bit of an oblong shape. Now I want you to switch to face select mode, and that is done right up here with this little face icon. or you can use your number 3 on your keyboard, and then select this row of faces. Hit Alternate and E to extrude faces, and you'll get this little menu. Select Extrude Faces along normals, and then just drag up ever so slightly to add just a little bit of extension here. Now I'm going to hit Shift on my keyboard as I drag to make the movements a little more precise, and I'm just going to scale it up maybe there. Then let's hit S and Z to constrain our scale by the Z, and I'm just going to scale that in a touch. Now let's tab back out of edit mode by hitting the tab key on our keyboard, or you can go to this drop down and select object mode, and then let's zoom out and look at our work. Let's change this view to solid so that we can see what it looks like. Hit Z on the keyboard, switch over here to solid mode, and there we go. We've got a good looking lollipop started here. Now what I want to do is to change the smooth shading on this object. So if we right click on it, right now we're on shade flat, but I want shade smooth. Select shade smooth, and then we're going to select a lollipop stick, right click, and select shade auto smooth for the stick. Now with this selected, we are going to add what's called a subdivision surface modifier. Go to this little blue wrench over here in the corner, hit add modifier, select generate, go down to subdivision surface and click. Right now, this is just gray, boring, clay-like material. Let's start making this look like a lollipop by adding materials. Select the candy portion of our lollipop and go over here to this little bouncing ball. It says material properties if you hover over it. Hit the new button, and now you've made a new material. We're going to change the color here on this base color by clicking on the white bar, and then we're just going to click and drag to where we want it to go. Now, nothing is happening here, and that is because we are not in the rendered mode. We are in solid mode. So let's switch over here to rendered, and now you can see a little bit of red has showed up, but it's really dark. It's dark because we need lights in our scene. So let's add one. Let's hit Shift and A to bring up our add menu and select light and then area light. I'm going to zoom out, grab this light, move it up on the Z-axis by hitting Z after I've hit G. Now we want to change the size of this light. Over here in this properties panel, we have a little light bulb. We can click that light bulb, and then let's change the size of this light. Let's make it 10 meters and see how big that is. Let's actually go to 25. Let's hit the R key on the keyboard for rotate, and you'll see that that can rotate our light. But I only want to rotate on the x-axis, so before I left click, I'm going to hit X on the keyboard, and then let's just rotate it like so. Now I'm going to hit G to grab it and move it, and hit Y to constrain the movement on the Y, and just move this back a little bit here. Now the reason we cannot see this light right now is because it's not bright enough in our scene. So let's change the power from 10 watts to 10,000 watts and see how that does. So let's finish the candy portion of the lollipop. Select that candy and then go over to the material properties panel again. Change the color to whatever color you want. Go to transmission and let's set the weight to 0.5. And then let's go down here and crank up the coat value just below the transmission up to 1 to give it a shiny coat. Now this isn't looking right. Something is odd. And that's because we need to switch to a different render engine. Go to this camera icon and scroll to the top where it says render engine. Use that drop down to select cycles. And then go down and make sure that this max samples underneath the render tab is set to nothing more than about 100. Okay, so now this is looking good. We can see the light passing through our candy, and we need to change the material on the sucker stick. So let's select it and select material properties, hit new. Let's select this base color and make sure it's all the way up to the white. And then let's change the roughness to something like 0.35. There we go. So let's add a camera so we can render out an image of our sucker. Hit Shift and A on your keyboard to bring up your add menu and scroll down here to camera and select camera. Now let's navigate our viewport view somewhere where we like the look of the sucker. Maybe something like here where we're able to see the reflection of the light on the sides of it and are able to see the light passing through. While you've got your camera selected, hit Control, Alternate, and 0 to snap your camera view to the current viewport view. Once you've got it there, you can hit Shift and the tilde key on your keyboard, which is the key just next to the number 1 at the top left, and then your mouse becomes a pointer for you to aim the camera where you would like. I'm going to set up the camera maybe right there, aiming at the sucker, and then I'm going to left click to apply that transformation. While we have this camera selected, let's change the focal length from 50 to something like 75. And then let's go over here to our output settings where it looks like a little printer, click that, and then let's change the resolution from 1920 by 1080 to 1080 by 1080 so that we have a square render. Now this is already looking fantastic, but we need a background for this image. So let's use the middle mouse wheel, click and drag to move out of the camera view. And then I'm going to hit Shift and A. Let's add a mesh plane. I'm going to grab that plane that I've just made, and I'm just going to move it backwards on the Y. And you can hit G to move it, Y to constrain the movement on the Y. And then I want to rotate it around this X-axis by 90 degrees. So to do that, I'm going to hit R while I have it selected, X to constrain along the X, and then I'm just gonna type in the number 90, 90, and enter to apply that transformation. Now let's move back to our camera view while we still have that selected. And we do this by hitting 0 on our number pad. 0 on the number pad, and now you can see that we have this plane right here. I'm going to hit G now on my keyboard to move it up kind of to the center of my view. And then I'm going to hit S and scale that up until it's filling the entire camera view. Let's go to Material Properties, and let's hit New to add a new material to that object. Now I can change the color to something that contrasts well with the surface of my sucker. We're ready to create a render now. So hit F12 on your keyboard or hit the render image button up here in the top left. Blender will bring up a new window and will begin processing the render here in the scene. Once it's done, you have the option to go to Image, Save As, and then you can navigate to somewhere on your computer, like your desktop here, and type in a name for your image. I'm gonna type in Lollipop and then Save As Image. Now you can open that image on your computer and begin sharing it with your friends. Congratulations on completing your first Lollipop render. If you'd like to show off your work, you're invited to join our Discord server that is full of beginning artists just like you. We'd love to see your work and be able to answer any additional questions that you might have about Blender or 3D. You'll find the link to the Discord server in the description below. And if you enjoyed this tutorial and want to learn more from us, then be sure to subscribe to our channel and check out our Blender Beginners course on our website.